Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Bisht from DPS Lamachur. Today in this session, we'll be starting with the new chapter, which is chapter number 7, that is depreciation. So before starting the chapter, let's understand what depreciation means. So depreciation means fall in the value of tangible fixed asset. So depreciation means when the value of tangible fixed asset decreases. Now what does tangible means? Tangible means anything which can be seen or touch is known as tangible. So tangible fixed assets here is plant and machinery, land and building, furnitures, etc. Now the fall in value of tangible fixed asset is due to, first reason is use of asset. See, by the constant use of asset in the business operation, it results in fall in the value of tangible asset. For example, if you have purchased a mobile phone for ₹10,000 and you are using that phone constantly for 6 months, after 6 months you decide to sell your mobile phone, so the selling price of that phone will be less than its cost price. Why? Because you have constantly used that phone for 6 months, so the value of that phone is decreased. That is why it is sold at the price less than its purchasing price. Similarly, in the business also, when the businessman purchases the machinery and uses that machinery for 10 to 15 hours per day, and if the businessman wish to sell that machinery after 10 years, then the value of machinery will decrease. The selling price of that machinery will be less than its cost price. Why? Because that machinery has been used for 10 years. So this is the reason why the value of fixed asset decreases by the constant use of that asset. Now the second reason is effluence of time, or we can say expiry of time. So this is the reason when the value of fixed asset decreases with the passage of time, even if that asset is not used for the business operations. For example, if you have purchased a mobile phone and you have not used that phone for 2 months, but if you sell that phone after 2 months, the selling price of that phone will be less than the purchasing price because the value of that phone has been decreased with the passage of time. So this is the reason why the value of fixed asset decreases with the expiry of time. Now the third reason is obsolescence. Now what does obsolescence means? Obsolescence means when the value of a fixed asset decreases due to technological advancement or innovation. This is the reason the value or the fixed assets of the company becomes outdated. For example, if you purchase a mobile phone for ₹50,000 and after 2 days a new mobile phone launches in the market with the latest technology and with the latest configuration figure, and the price of that phone is ₹20,000. So here the company who has produced that phone or produced that product for ₹50,000, the product of that company will become outdated. Why? Because the same product is available in the market with the latest technology at the reasonable price. So this is the reason why the value of fixed assets of a company decreases due to obsolescence. Now, there are some important terms in depreciation. First is amortization. Now, what does amortization mean? Amortization means fall in the value of intangible fixed assets. So when the value of intangible fixed assets of a company decreases, it is termed as amortization. Now, what are intangible? What does intangible means? Intangible means the things which we cannot see or which we cannot touch. That is termed as intangible. So, the intangible fixed assets are goodwill, patents, trademark, etc. So, these assets, when the value of these assets decreases, it is known as amortization. The difference between amortization and depreciation is, in amortization, there is a fall in the value of intangible fixed assets, whereas in depreciation, there is a fall in the value of tangible fixed assets. Now, the next term is depletion. So, what does depletion means? Depletion means fall in the value of wasting assets. Wasting assets can be natural resources, that is iron ore, coal mine, etc. So depletion here means when the value of wasting assets decreases. Now, wasting assets can be natural resources such as iron ore, coal mine, etc. Now, we will discuss some factors affecting depreciation. So, the first factor is cost. Now, what does cost mean? Cost means the price at which the machinery is purchased. So, the actual cost of the asset is determined when the various expenses for purchasing that asset is added to the price of that machinery. It is termed as cost. Now, here, when a businessman purchases a machinery, it is termed as purchasing price. So, purchasing the machinery is not enough for the business. There are some expenses such as installation expenses. Now, when the machinery is purchased, this machinery needs to be installed in the business. For that, the business has to pay some installation expenses. There are some erection charges also. Erection charges means when these machinery are placed in the business, these machinery basically replaces the old machinery. So, the whatever space which is covered by the old machinery, it is to be replaced with the new machinery. So, for clearing that space, the business has to pay some erection charges. And there are some other charges also. So, by adding all these expenses to the purchases price, the cost of actual cost of machinery is determined. Okay, so these are some expenses which need to be added for determining the cost of asset. And these are also termed as capitalization. Capitalization, it is termed as capitalization in accounting terms, or we can say it as capital expenditure. These are termed in accounting terms. So, all these expenses in accounting terms is known as capitalization. Capitalization means when all these expenses are added to the purchasing price, we called it as capitalization. Now, the second factor is estimated residual or scrap value. So here, estimated residual or scrap value means when the businessman assumes the estimated sale value of an asset at the end of its useful life. For example, if a businessman has purchased a machinery for 50,000, now the businessman assumes that after 10 years of its serviceable life, the value of machinery will be rupees 20,000. So here rupees 20,000 will be the estimated scrap value. Now, one more important thing in this is depreciable amount is calculated as cost minus estimated scrap value. Now, the last factor affecting depreciation is estimated useful life of asset. So here the businessman assumes the estimated useful life of an asset in terms of number of years that asset is used for the business operation. We have learned the basic concept of depreciation. In the next session, we'll continue with some methods of calculating depreciation. That's all for today. Thank you.